Hello students, this video we start with endosperm. Endosperm is developed is after fertilization. Primary endosperm nucleus developed into endosperm. The primary endosperm nucleus formed by triple fusion. The triple fusion is the fusion of two polar nuclei with one male gamete. Two polar nuclei is diploid in nature, one gamete is haploid in nature to form endosperm. Endosperm is triploid in nature. So the number of cell involved in fusion is called triple. So the fusion is triple fusion. The endosperm is 3N in nature. The functions of endosperm is to gives the nourishes the developing embryo. The type of embryo, the type of endosperm is 3. It may be nuclear endosperm, cellular endosperm and helopial endosperm. First we see the nuclear endosperm. Primary endosperm nucleus undergoes several mitotic division into form nuclear endosperm without wall formation. The nuclear endosperm forms without wall formation. Example is coccinia, capsula and arachis. Next, the cellular endosperm is formed by the primary endosperm divides into two nuclei. The primary endosperm nucleus divides into two nuclei followed by wall formation occurs in the endosperm is called a cellular endosperm. The example of cellular endosperm is Adaxa, Helianthus. And next, the helopial endosperm. The primary endosperm nucleus moves towards the base of the embryo sac is called a helopial endosperm. It is further divides into two nuclei. The helopial endosperm moves towards the embryo sac and divides into two nuclei. The example of helopial endosperm is hydrilla and vallisneria, water plants. Next, we see the seed. After the endosperm formation, it may be a seed is developed. Fertilized ovule is seed. The seed is fertilized ovule. Ovule is developed into seed, ovary developed into fruit and integument developed into seed coat. A mature seed which is consist of embryo, endosperm and seed coat. The seed may be endospermous. Based on the presence and absence of endosperms, the seed may be classified into two types. The presence of endosperms in seed is called a endospermous or albuminous seed. The example of endospermous seed is wheat and maize. The non-endospermous seed is which does not consist endosperm is called a ex-albuminous endosperm. The example of non-endospermous seed is bean and mango. We see the structure of dicot seed. Dicot is the seed is consist of two cotyledons is called a dicotyledons. The example of dicotyledon seed is Sizer aryatum, Bengal gram. The seed is consist of funicle and micropyle and seed coat. The funicle is leaves the small scars is called a hilum. The funicle attached with the ovule or seed, the place is hilum. The funicle is leaves from the seed, it is leaves the scars, it is called a hilum. The small pores like structures which present in the seed is called a micropyle, which is used for entry of
oxygen and water.
Oxygen and water enters the through the micropylar region. The seed is consist of two coat. The outer coat is called a tester. Tester is very thick in nature, whereas the tegma is very thin in nature. The upper part of the embryo is epicotyl. Epicotyl region is shoot part. The lower part of the embryonic stage of the seed is called a hypocotyl, which means the lower part of the root is hypocotyl. The developed or developing embryo is consist of plumule and radicle. Plumule is developed as shoot, stem part, and radicle develop as root part. The next move on the structure of monocot seed. What is monocotyledons? The monocotyledons is consist of seed with single cotyledons. The example of monocot seed is Oryza sativa. The Oryza sativa seed or paddy seed is one seeded, so it is called as karyopsis. One seeded seeds are all belongs to karyopsis fruit. The outer region of reed coat is brownish in color, which was you can see the seed of Oryza paddy seed. The shield shaped structure. Shield shaped structure which around the cotyledons or then shoot and root particles is called a scutellum. The root part is radicle. The shoot part is plumule. Again, the coleorrhiza and coleoptile is the characteristic features of monocot seed. Which is, what is the functions of coleoptile is, it is protect the shoot part of the seed or embryo. And what is the functions of coleorrhiza is, it is protect the root and root cap. Coleoptile function is protecting shoot part. And coleorrhiza protecting root cap and root, protecting by coleorrhiza. Next we see the next topic.